Today I am conducting the experiment of Brinell hardness number. This is the experiment. Now this is the tableau column. We have to find out the Brinell hardness number for ferrous material 187.5, major diameter 250 mm, minor diameter for non-ferrous material. These are the major diameter for the ferrous and non-ferrous. The indenter will be 2.5 mm, 5 mm. This is the tableau column. This is the ferrous material, mild steel, cast iron. Now indenter used is 2.5 mm. Diameter indenter. This is a 2.5 mm diameter indenter is we are going to use. For non-ferrous material, this is the non-ferrous material. We are using the 5 mm indenter diameter. Now, this is the plot form. For ferrous material, we have to fix 187.5 kg and fix the indenter here with the help of Allen key. You have to fix here. Now indenter is fixed here. Cast iron is placed over the platform. With the help of elevating screw, rotate clockwise direction such that the specimen touches to the indenter. As it touches to the indenter, we have to apply the minor load, 3 kg, a small needle moves anti-clockwise direction 3 kg and larger needle moves 0. Small 3 kg, larger will be 0. Now apply the load. The larger load needle will moving in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, as the larger needle stops, you have to wait for 1 minute in case of Brinell hardness number. In case of Rockwell hardness number, you have to wait for 30 seconds. Wait for 1 minute. Then, unload it. Unloading should be slowly. You have to carry it out. Go for next trial. Because here we are using microscope in order to find out the indented diameter. Go for next position. After getting the indentation with the help of a chop piece, you have to mark over the indent. This is the part. This is the indenter. This is the indentation. This is the indentation. I have done it. Again, I will do for second indentation. I will place over the platform. Apply 3 kg minor load. Load is applied. This is the second trial. We are performing it. As the larger needle stops, wait for 1 minute. Next, unload it. Move the anti-clockwise rotation. Remove the specimen from the platform. Go for marking here. Go for other color chop piece in order to get. This is the indenter here. There are two indenters, this and this. Next, I will go for third indentation. Place over the platform. Rotated, 3 kg minor load is applied. Load is applied here. As the larger needle is moving in anti-clockwise direction, I am performing the faster way. But in exam, you have to wait for 1 minute for the so that the material enter into the plastic region. Now wait for 1 minute. Now unload it. unload it. Anti-clockwise rotation. Now mark the specimen with the help of other choppies. The three indentations. This one more is here, one more is here, one more is here. Now, with the help of this microscope, place over the specimen. That part here. Now there is a marking over here. Count the line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That means the first indentation is 10. 10 is nothing but 1.0 yard right. The second reading is again, count the line, it is 11. 11 means you are right, 1.1. I will go for third. Third reading, it is 1.1. 11 is nothing but you have to consider 1.1. Consider 1.1. In this way, you have to perform the test. I have considered the ferrous cast iron. From the microscope, this is the microscope, you have to find out, and after getting this value, go for mean and substitute in the formula. In case of ferrous material, please change the value, load 250, and indent will be 5 mm, and it has to be fixed here, and you have to repeat the procedure, same procedure you have to repeat. After taking the readings over that of the specimen, this is the specimen, aluminium and brass, and you have to check into the microscope. The same procedure you have to repeat. You have to wait for 1 minute here. Weight is 250.